Welcome to the statics tutorials. So in this problem, we need to solve for the reactions. We have a beam AB that has a fixed support here at A. So that means it's embedded in the wall or bolted to the wall here at A. We have a 10 kilonewton per meter distributed load that acts over 2 meters. The distributed load is 10 kilonewtons per meter here, but it's triangular, so it goes down to zero here. Then we have a 75 kilonewton concentrated force that acts here another 1 meter over. And then we have a 25 kilonewton meter couple moment that's negative or clockwise at point B. So let's draw our free body diagram. So our fixed support, we cannot translate the beam in X because it's fixed to the wall. We cannot translate the beam in Y because it's fixed to the wall. And we also can't rotate the beam around point A because it's fixed to the wall. So its reactions are going to be the AX force to prevent the X translation, the Y force, AY, to prevent the Y translation, and then the moment at A to prevent rotation around point A. Then we include our distributed load, our concentrated force here, and then also our couple moment at the very end of the beam. So we can do our sum of forces in the X direction. AX is our only force in the X direction, so we just get AX is equal to zero. We can do our sum of forces in the Y. We have our force from our distributed load here, so it's a triangle, so it's going to be 1/2 of the base times the height, so the 2 meters here times the height of 10 kilonewton per meter. And then we have minus the 75 kilonewton concentrated force, and then plus the AY is equal to zero. We can solve this equation. We just have the one unknown, and so we get AY is equal to 85 kilonewtons, and then we can do sum of moments about A. We have this MA from the support, so we need to add it in our equation. We give it a positive or counterclockwise sense, so it's going to be positive in our equation here. And then we have our distributed load. So remember, all of this stuff here is really just the force. So 1/2 the base times the height of our distributed load. Now we need to multiply it by the distance. Remember that the centroid of the triangle is going to be 1/3 over from the side. And so we're going to do 1/3 times the 2 meters, and that'll give us our distance back to A. That moment's going to be negative about point A. And then we have our 75 kilonewtons times the 3 meters total that it acts, 2 meters plus the 1 meter. It's also negative. And then we have our 25 kilonewton meters at the very end that's negative. So that all sums to equal to zero. And we can solve that. MA is our only unknown. And we'll get MA is equal to 257 kilonewtons. Thanks for watching.